It was over 40 years ago that Sam J. Jones burst onto our screens as Flash Gordon, the savior of the universe. It was a role that catapulted Sam to worldwide fame and to cult icon, still loved by millions of fans. Sam J. Jones caught up with our Craigie Bennett at Supernova in Brisbane to chat about life after Flash. Flash!
Years in showbiz and counting. And you know what, when people start off their careers, it might be as a dead body, back to camera, something like that. You wound up as Bo Derek's husband in 10.
Yes. During that process of making the film 10 was also the beginning of the interview process with Dino De Laurentiis for Flash Gordon.
Is that right?
Yeah, so he asked me, I heard you doing a movie with Blake Edwards. Now, I had a small part. I only had one line of dialogue. He said, well, what kind of role do you have? I said, a very big role. I sort of embellished that a little bit, yeah.
Is this true? You'd been on a dating show, and somebody saw you and said, that is Flash Gordon. Is that right?
Well yes, factually, accurately. Dino De Laurentiis' mother-in-law was in the house, his house, said, Dino, come here. And looking at the show called The Dating Game, where they would hire certain unknown actors to come in to pose as the potential date. And she said, Dino, there is your Flash Gordon right there on TV.
Did you have fun making Flash Gordon?
Oh, I did. Yeah. It's always a blessing working. I mean, I refer to Flash Gordon as the, I think we talked about this, the triple blessing.
Yes.
First blessing is we're hired.
Yes.
People want us.
Yep.
We have value. So first one is getting hired. Second is if we do well in whatever we're doing in life, the project does well. And the third is what we're talking about right now. The triple, the third blessing is longevity.
Correct.
That's what we're doing.
Did you realize when you were making that, Sam, that A, that movie was just so outrageously campy, but B, that people all around the world were going to love that and you for decades after?
You don't know that in the beginning. Again, you're just so grateful for working. But I knew, and I think the reason why it's going on, it's timeless, it's encouraging, it's inspirational. Why? Because they look at Flash Gordon and they say, number one, he doesn't have any superpowers. He's just a guy. If he can do that in the middle of all this adversity and challenges, by golly, I can do that.
Yeah.
I think that's why people relate to him. That's why he's relevant now.
There was that little thing called Playgirl, 1975.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
You peeled off.
Almost
completely.
Everything, yeah.
Got to see the lot dangling around in the breeze. Yeah. Was that intimidating, seriously?
Well, first of all, why did I do it? My hero at the time was Burt Reynolds.
Yes.
In the 70s, he was iconic. And I said, well, if Burt Reynolds can do it, I can do it. It's kind of uncomfortable. I mean, thank God it was just myself and the photographer. But now you're on a movie set and you're kind of almost naked. And there's 80 people there.
Oh, yeah.
So I don't know how you do it. I mean, there's no way. You're just, and it's cold. Wait a minute, it's cold?
That's it. People look at you now and they think, my gosh, pop culture icon, loved all over the world. You've also had and been very candid about dark times in your life, falling into depression after Flash Gordon.
Yeah.
Phone didn't ring. You got stuck on the wacky tobacky. You know, all these things have gone on in your life, though, and you're honest about it.
Yeah.
How did that happen? Why did somebody like you, so larger than life and with such an energy and a light, how did you fall into that dark despair?
Well, I think for men, I can only speak on behalf of men. My wife, of course, helps the ladies, but it's choices. You know, it all comes down to choices. We either make good choices or bad choices. And I was making some kind of foolish choices. I think the number one thing I did, and I know, you know, marijuana is a big issue now, it's all over the world, but I medicated myself. When the phone wasn't ringing, but see, it's also a posturing. It's how we posture ourselves, our thoughts, our words. In other words, I'm watching a movie on TV. Instead of me saying about that actor, oh, that's so cool, he did such a great job. See, I wasn't saying that. I was saying, why didn't they hire me? I could have done a better job. But this was an everyday addiction. And what it was doing for me, it was making me happy, but it was a false, deceptive happiness. And the voices in my head were saying, oh, the phone will ring tomorrow. You just need to smoke some more pot so you can get happy again, okay? And when you find yourself going outside, it's also a separation. You're separating yourself from your family. I was so good at it, Craig, that my wife didn't know what I was doing.
You are an absolute joy, Sam.
Thank you so much.
Always a pleasure chatting with you.
So much. Thank you so much.
Your power's fading me.